Hello, and welcome to How Do I Use OData Web Services to Modify Data in Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2013 R2 video. My name is Vjekoslav Babic. I'm a Microsoft Dynamics NAV MVP, and I have created this video for you in cooperation with Microsoft and Platan, Microsoft Solution Training Center from Belgium. At the end of this video, you will have a simple application which allows you to read and write data into Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2013 R2 using OData Web Services. The objective of this video is to introduce writable OData Web Services, to read data from the application, and then to create, update, and delete data in the application using an OData service reference. I will do this in four steps. In the first step, I will configure OData Web Service. In the second step, I will connect to the OData Web Service from a .NET application. In the third step, I will read data from the OData source using link. And in the fourth step, I will add, modify, and delete data. Let's get started and let's configure OData Web Services. My first task is to enable OData Web Services. To make sure that the OData Web Services are enabled, I'm going to select my Dynamics NAV 7.0 instance in my Microsoft Dynamics NAV Server Administration tool, and then I will expand the OData Services FAST tab. Here I have Enable OData Services checkbox. You must make sure that this checkbox is selected. I can verify that the OData Web Services are enabled by opening my browser window and then navigating to the URL. So the default URL is the name of the computer where web services are running, the port number, then the instance name, which is Dynamics NAV 7.1, then OData. So here I can see that I have received a document which has the default entity in the OData web services in NAV, which is company. My next step is to actually publish the customer card page as a web service. So I will search for web services. I will run the page and then I will create a new web service. So here I will select the object type of page, object ID 21, which corresponds to customer card, and I will call this service name customer. I'll click publish and then I will receive the OData URL and SOAP URL. So this OData URL shows me how to access this web service from a browser window or from any application which accesses Microsoft Dynamics NAV through OData. Let me test. So I'm going back to my browser window and then I will refresh my URL and then I can see that I actually have my company and my customer entities. If I go back to NAV and I select the OData URL, so I will copy, paste this URL into my OData, my browser window. Since I'm accessing from the local host, I'm going to delete the host name because that will cause authentication issues, and I will simply paste localhost. When accessing from outside, then I would have to use the fully qualified domain name for my server. So here I'm just accessing it using localhost and then I will press enter and then my document will load and now I see my customer entity data. It shows as a data feed, so it uses the default template for showing data fields. I can change that and I can actually see the XML. So for that I would actually have to access tools, then internet options, then content, then feeds and web slices settings, and then I will switch off turn on feed reading view. And then I will click OK. And then OK. I will copy my URL, I will close the browser window and restart it. And then I will access the same URL again. And here I'm able to see my customer feed containing all of the OData information about my customers. In the next step, I will create a new .NET application and then I will add a service reference to Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2013 R2 OData Web Services. I will start by creating a new project. It doesn't really matter which project this is, because I'm simply demonstrating how to connect to OData. So you can create a console application, or you could create a Windows Presentation Framework application, or a Windows Forms application, whichever you prefer. I'm simply going to call this application OData Demo. And I will click OK to start creating a new application. Then my Visual Studio creates my new Windows Forms application. And my next step is going to be to add the service reference to my OData source. Right-click References, and I will click Add Service Reference. Here in the address bar, I'm going to enter the address to my OData web services URL. So it's going to be http localhost 7048 dynamics NAV 71 OData. And I will click Go. So it connected to the service, it calls it NAV, and here I have company and customer entities. What I'm going to use is give this default service reference one namespace a new name, so I'm just going to call it NAV OData, and I will click OK. At this stage, I can see that I have a new service reference, which is NAV OData. And here I have all of my proxy classes, which allow me to connect to the OData web services and communicate to the OData web services using default functionality that the OData protocol underlying the service reference actually allows me to do. Now that I have my application, I will write code to read data from the OData source, and I will use link to do so. I will now add some controls to my Windows Forms application. So I will first resize my form, and then I'm going to add a data grid view. I will use this data grid view just to show information in a visual way, even though I don't require a grid view to read OData services. And I'm also going to add a button. So I will set the text property to refresh, and when I click this button, I'm going to load the data into my grid. So let's take a look at how to read the data using C# code when accessing OData web services. So I will start by referencing my NAV OData namespace, and then NAV, and I'm going to give it a variable name. I'll call it NAV, and this is going to be new NAVODATA.NAV. And here I'm going to, I have to specify the URL that I'm accessing, where my OData is residing. So I can type new URI, and then type the URL. So the URL is HTTP localhost 7048 dynamics NAV 71 OData. And here I will specify which company I'm reading from. So here I will type company, and then here I'm going to filter the data belonging to a specific company. So I will type Kronos International. This percentage 20, this is just how the URL encodes the space character, and then LTD. So this is my URL that contains the customers belonging to this company. In case you have more companies, you definitely must specify the URL of a specific company. Otherwise, you might not be able to filter on a company. So I will open my browser window again, and then I will test this URL. So here I can see that I have my company filtered to Kronos International LTD, and that I'm going to select the customers. So I will close my browser window. Next step will be to actually authenticate my OData web services. So depending on how I'm accessing the URL, I might have different options here. I'm going to show the simplest one, so I'm just going to use my built-in credentials. So I'm specifying credentials is credential cache, and then default network credentials. So here I'm going to use system.net namespace where my credential cache class is defined. In my next step, I'm going to read the data. So here, I'm going to write the code which actually reads the data using link. So I could type something like var customers and then write a link query, something like from C in NAV customer select C. So this would actually read my customer data from the OData web service and store it in my customers variable. So if I run my application and actually I set the debugger breakpoint at this position, I will be able to see the data which was retrieved. So I'm running my application, I'm going to click the refresh button, and here I have my breakpoint being hit. So I'm going to step over, and now my customers contains data. If I open and open the results view here, I'm going to see the list of customers which have been retrieved. So for example, customer and then customer number, etc. So let's take a look at the type of the customers variable. So I will type customers get type to see what is the type. So here I can see that this is data service ordered query, and unfortunately I cannot use this to directly bind to my grid. So if I did something like that, I wouldn't see any data. So if I try something like data grid view 1.data source equals customers, I wouldn't see anything. So I can verify that if I click start and then click refresh again and then step over, I will see that my data grid is empty. However, if I convert this customers variable into list, so if I say to list, my data grid view can bind to a generic list. So if I run this application now, what I will see is that when I refresh and then bind a list, that grid view binding took a little time, and then when I run the application I can see that here I have the list of all of the customers from my Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2013 R2 database. So I'm going to close this application. So here I can take a look at various ways of how I can actually select data. So in the first example I've accessed the data using a simple link query. I can also use direct invocation of link namespace methods. So for example here I can say nav.customer. And then enter a predicate. So C name and then for example starts with and then use C to find the customers which start with C. So this is another example of how to use link to actually access my customers. So if I run this application now, I would see just a list of customers that start with letter C. So this is a simple way of how to access data in the read mode. And finally, I'm ready to add, modify and delete data. So in this step I will create a new customer, I will modify an existing customer, and I will delete an existing customer from the application. I'll first starting by adding a couple of buttons. So I will add one more button. This will be create. Then one more button that will represent the modify operation, and finally I'm going to add one more button for delete. So in my create button, again I can start by copying this piece of code. I could have used a private member of this class, but it doesn't really matter if I recreate a new instance. So here what I can do is write the code to create a new customer. So I will start by typing var and then customer is new NAV OData and then customer, and here I'm going to enter some information about my customer. So I'm going to say that name is OData web services writable demo, that address is 1 Microsoft way. And credit limit is 15,000. My next step is going to be to actually feed this customer into my NAV customers. So here what I'm going to do is nav.add to customer, and then I'm going to specify the instance. So I'm adding my customer. And finally, I'm going to call nav.saveChanges. So this will create a new customer in my NAV. I'll run this application and then I will click the create button. Then I'm going to click refresh, and I'm going to change the code first. So since I've used O, I'm also going to filter to start with O, and then I'm going to refresh. I will see that here I have my OData web service writable demo. Also, I can verify in my customer list in NAV. So I can see that it is created, and that if I open it, I can see that this is the credit limit. Let's now create the code to actually modify and delete the customer. So I'm going to select the modify button. I'll copy my NAV instance here, and I'm going to select a customer. This time I'm going to use link again. So I will say var customer is nav.customer, and then where customer which has number equal to C. Actually, I'm going to copy the customer number from NAV just to make sure it's the same. And then I'm going to type first to select the first instance from the list of returned customers. Then I'm going to say that customer credit limit is actually 20,000, and that customer.name is actually OData demo alone without anything else. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to store this in my customer list. NAV, and then update object, and then I will enter my customer reference. And finally, my last step is nav save changes. So I'm going to start my application. I'll first refresh to retrieve the list of customers. So here I can see that I have my OData web services writable demo. I'll click modify, and then I'll click refresh again, and here I can see that it is OData demo. I can also verify in NAV that it is 20,000 of credit limit. I will click OK, and I will minimize my role-tailored client for Windows again. And finally, my last step is to call the delete method, or actually to remove a customer. So I'm going to start with the same three lines of code. So I'm selecting the customer from the database, and then I'm going to enter NAV delete object. And here I'm going to add the reference to my customer. And finally, as you could have imagined, I'm calling NAV save changes. So I will run my application again. I will refresh the data to show that the customer is in there. Then I will click delete, and I will refresh again, and then I will see that I have an empty list. And also, if I go to my role-tailed client for Windows, and if I refresh the view, my customer is gone from the list. And that was it. I hope you enjoyed this video, which explained how to create, modify, and delete data using OData Web Services in Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2013 R2. And I'm looking forward to seeing you in other videos in this series. Thank you.